Well, joining us now is Dr. Tony Liachon himself. Dr. Liachon, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Carmina, and to your televiewers. Magandang hapon po sa inyo lahat.
All right, so let's try to clarify some things as we talk this afternoon. A couple of days back, we had former Health Secretary Janet Garin on the program, and she said something interesting. She said, you were never even appointed. And it was, short of saying, it was just you going around media telling about this appointment. What is the truth here, Dr. Liachon?
It's a complete lie. It's a complete lie. I was invited by Secretary Ted Herbosa. You see, politicians can just go around because of their influence and power. They can actually, wield their power without actually validating those facts. I mean, I don't have to go around because I'm every day in the news. So I have difficulty really adjusting my schedule because of so many interviews, not only related to this one, but a lot of things. So I cannot be, doing a lot of things. I have also cleaning. And I don't need a position. I don't need a title to lead. I've been leading since 15 years ago. So I think it's a complete lie. And I'm very sorry that an influential politician will try to poison the minds of many people. And for the record, it's a complete lie. And I'm sorry it's coming from someone that we should actually be believing. But I'm sorry, it's a complete lie. And that's quite irresponsible to start with.
So now you've come to a decision that you're completely walking away. How difficult, how easy was that decision to make, and what were your reasons for doing so?
It was not easy because, number one, I want really to help, like in the pandemic. When my sister died when I was 50 years old in 2011, I volunteered myself to be one peso consultant for the Department of Health under Secretary Ona. And that was the time I met USEC Ted Herbosa. So we worked on the SIN tax law of 2012 signed by President Aquino. And it was the greatest bill in more than a decade. Perhaps the greatest bill ever. Because it has reduced the prevalence rate of smoking and quadruple or perhaps quintuple the budget of the Department of Health. And for every increase in the inflation or the prices, we can actually increase the SIN product. So it's quite important. But during the pandemic, something occurred. Despite the reduction of smoking alcohol, the killer diseases have gone into orbit. You have a lot of heart attack. Number two would be stroke and then cancer. Diabetes, number four. A lot of the patients on dialysis, lung diseases and hypertension. So I think it's a lofty goal. I want to contribute to the government. And my target, I told Secretary Herbosa, the lifespan of Philippines is 71. And watching the Netflix live up to 100, that's the blue zone. The target, I told Secretary Bosa, is to extend the lifespan or the life expectancy of Filipinos from 71 to 80 in the next 10 years. Perhaps in the next 5 years, after the term of President Bongbong Marcos, we can actually extend our lifespan to 75 and then 75 to 80, just like the progressive Asian countries like Japan, 85, Singapore, South Korea, and the rest. But you need a game plan. So I told the secretary, the greatest reason why we fail in health is actually education. So education, ignorance. So education is key. So we need to insert that into the curriculum.
So I'm sorry to cut you there, Dr. Liachon, but I got to put this in edgewise. So now that you've completely walked away, what's going to happen to that intention to serve the nation now in this game plan that you speak of?
Well, I'm going to advocate that. We have a civil society movement right now being formed, And I have forged some partnership program like in Bataan to convert that to a blue zone area in La Union. In Quezon City, we have transformed our Kill COVID civil society group. Multiple stakeholders, not only medicine. Perhaps we would like to partner with progressive thinkers, leaders like Mayor Joy Belmonte. And then transform that into blue zone and other areas. So the essentially the mantra is to teach, to heal, partner with medical group, and to lead the influential leaders who can actually make changes in the next 10 years. That's the timeline that we are doing. The other reason why it's difficult, because Secretary Tederbos is a friend. We met yesterday morning. He offered breakfast. We met the UK ambassador and talk about health human resource and non-communicable disease. Mm-hmm. We parted ways, nice, but I didn't talk about resigning. But on my way back, reflecting, I was expecting the HR director to be there. So that to redefine my contract, I need a timeline or meetings structured because we don't have much time. And I'd like an explanation why he did not defend me during the budget hearing when he knew for a fact, shameless to say, that I was one of the leaders of the Syntax Law. I was field health director during the time of Secretary Garin, believe it or not. She was the Secretary of Health when I was Field Health Director. I participated in the UHC. And during the pandemic, I was summoned to lead by President Duterte.
Yeah, so you're saying you were expecting the Secretary to defend you. That didn't happen. Did that contribute as well to your decision to just walk away? And have you heard from the Secretary since making this decision? What did he have to say, Dr. Lechon? That's the final question.
The final question, I think the Secretary did not lift a finger to defend me in an open forum. That's one. And he immediately told the Congresswoman that my position as special advisor will be reverted to a voluntary. And that was really painful for my family. I worked so hard doing the blueprint. And I expect more than that coming from the secretary. But he texted this morning, the resignation letter is accepted, and he asked me whether I would like to still help him. Of course, Ted. But right now, I just want to pull back a little and focus on my family, my clinic, and health advocacies. But there are silver linings, and perhaps when one door closes, another door will open.
All right.
And let's keep it at that.
Okay. And we're going to have to leave it at that. Dr. Tony Lechon, their health reform advocate, thank you for joining us this soon. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Carmine.
Take care.